Just days after the federal budget was handed down, Deloitte says they're disappointed in the reduction of concessional contribution caps to $25,000 and would have instead liked to have seen a lifetime contribution cap implemented so that people are encouraged to save for their retirement. His partner of Deloitte, Russell Mason, with more.
The government is trying to balance the budget, and with over $2 trillion in superannuation, it is an area that the government would look to raise more revenue from. It was not surprising that the government decided that anything in the retirement phase in excess of $1.6 million would be subject to tax, and that's something that I think many in the industry have been expecting for some time. However, we were disappointed that the government reduced the concessional contribution cap down from the current $30,000 or $35,000, depending on your age, to $25,000, that they put a lifetime cap of $500,000 on the non-concessional contributions. Higher income earners in particular will look at alternative saving methods to superannuation. Could we see a trend more towards negative gearing? That's a possibility, or other saving vehicles. The losers are the higher income earners, that top 3 or 4% of earners who will be paying more tax on their contributions, as they've now said those earning in excess of $250,000 per annum will pay a 30% tax on contribution rather than a 15% tax. The winners will be lower income workers, those under $37,000, for whom there's a rebate of the tax that is paid on their employer contributions. Also, where their partner is able to pay money on their behalf into superannuation and claim a tax deduction or rebate.
Russell Mason says the majority of the population believe that their SG contributions are enough to retire on, which is another reason why the concessional contribution cap shouldn't be reduced.
We would like the government to reinstate the previous concessional caps and to look at considering a lifetime contribution cap, which would allow people to catch up later on in life when they perhaps have the spare money and extra money to put into superannuation. Especially women who may spend time out of the workforce having and raising children, and older workers who have paid off their mortgage, the children have left home, and they're now in a position to catch up.